A student uses a heavy ball attached to a rope as a pendulum in an experiment. The ball is hanging so the rope is vertical. The student pulls the ball back and releases it from rest, as shown. Comparing the measured value to the expected value of the speed of the ball at the lowest point of its swing, the student finds that the ball is moving slower than expected. Which of the following may account for the slower than expected speed? Probably the best way to find a reasonable explanation for this phenomenon is to go over the answers one at a time and try to determine whether the explanation is reasonable or not. Let's do that. A. The student measured the mass of the ball to be higher than it actually is. If you ignore any change in mechanical energy caused by the environment, you should have that the initial gravitational potential energy is equal to the final kinetic energy at the bottom of the swing. This results in mass times gravitational acceleration times the height at the beginning is equal to 1/2 times the mass times the speed of the ball squared at the bottom. Clearly, the mass cancels out, which means that the speed does not depend on the mass. Therefore, a wrong measurement in the mass should not affect the measurement of the speed. B. The student did not account for the mass of the rope. If the mass of the rope is not negligible, then the gravitational potential energy that we have at the beginning is distributed into two different kinds of energy: the kinetic energy of the bob, which is translational, and the rotational kinetic energy of the rope. The first one depends on the mass of the ball, but the second one depends on the inertia of the whole rope. We can have more inertia because of the combined mass of the rope and bob. Therefore, even if the kinetic energy is the same, the speed will be less. This is a reasonable explanation, so our best choice is option B.